kind of marveled at that, because it was like, well, what about if you and Hannah, this is before we had met, do like something, like a
tour,
walking tour, something
walking
kind of
tour.
Basically like the flaneur, the flaneuse, you know, walking the streets.
Because we both had this sort of collecting things from the streets and walking as part of our practice or being out in the streets and in the world.
I don't even know that much about my
that's
work.
What I'm assuming.
I don't think you. And by the way, I think this is the first time we're actually seeing much in depth of each other's work. Others
that's
work,
true.
So, you know. I did know when I looked you up, though, I did know the Annie collaboration with
yeah.
Annie. You know,
yeah.
And I thought, oh, yeah, she'll be all right. And then, and as soon as we met, I don't know, it seemed like a good fit for some reason. I don't know why. We
yeah.
both had an interest in thinking about walk. We were like, what areas do we like? And we both have an interest in this kind of Third Street area, this
Candlestick and the, for my piece in there, and then the shoreline all around where the shipyards are. So Allison made this painting of the former shoreline of San Francisco.
With the contemporary line.
So this, and this is up in her studio, and this seems like, oh yeah, this is like a clear geographical crossover for both of us. And so we started thinking about just exploring that area together and walking. We started taking walks on Third Street and sort of trying to find out more about the area and how we could, if there was anything, if there would be anything we could do.
And just a interest in like the rapid changes that are happening there and the gentrification and trying to pinpoint there what are crossover spaces where two different communities can actually cross over, and there are a few. There's like that pizza place is an amazing thing. And
it's sort of this pizza place across from the Flora Grub that's open. It's like an open sort of
lot.
Park and
heavy. Has anybody been there?
So a lot of different kinds of people.
It's a real crossroad. It's kind of meets many different demographics, and then it's this open space. It's really kind of beautiful, and kind of trying to contemplate like what that would be, but that turns into a huge problems, and there's a lot of problematic issues with Hannah and I, two white women walking down the street thinking, you know, that
like
there's something,
not knowing that, you know, that much about the area really.
Yeah.
And just like being so sort of new to exploring it, so
yeah. And that's what got us thinking about, well, it's always helpful to have a role for yourself, you know, like uniforms and a specific purpose, so then you have a purpose for being somewhere and not just randomly doing things. And plus we were just like digging the depths, you know, when you were starting this collaboration. It's like, I don't know what we're doing. And so we had gone into some African amulet things where there's chicken feet on the tree in front, and, you know, and went in and they're talking to the lady, and they have all these little amulets and stuff. So then we thought, oh, we'll make our own amulet. And we buried all these, this was our first project together, we buried all these secret aspirations in here in the sewing of it. And all the things we were afraid of, the missteps we were going to do, constantly negotiating on that. So we had taken those somehow to give us,
something.
And sewing.
We made something. This was
just something
first
to do.
Thing we made.
Oh, that's awesome.
But you know, just the random of standing, and I like that process too. It's kind of stepping into the dark to try to figure out something to do together. And then we were like, why?
We had also gone to the navigation center that's over by the what street is that? There's
24th.
There's
to 24th. It's a new navigation center. The Episcopal Services is starting them. They have three of them now for homeless people. And it's really an attractive place. So it's just investigating the place, you know, and just becoming interested. interested in the things that people were doing to try to negotiate these rapidly changing places, and also just the amount of homelessness and stuff on the street.
But that was sort of at the same time as we were feeling like this is like kind of too big of a geographical location for us to take on in a short time, and so we decided to come back to the civic center, and to walk around Civic Center and think more about Civic Center as a kind of crossroads of a lot of different kinds of people, and City Hall as a crossroads of a lot of different.
And it is really pretty interesting, all these buildings that you can walk into that are public buildings, like the Department of Public Health and all this. And then we just started noticing the unused spaces in all these spaces, like little light wells.
This is our tour of, we got this tour of City Hall. This was.
We were seeing all these doors and we're like, I want to hang out here. We want our own residency in here. You know, and also we were also thinking about all these cabinets that were empty up, and because we were going in like, where can we walk in all these public buildings? What is not off limits?
This is right outside the mayor's office, looking
balcony.
Looking over at that balcony. So we got to all around.
Thinking, and briefly we're thinking what an amazing project it would be to curate a kind of a public art show in all these unused spaces, like these little white light wells and unused cabinets in obscure places in all these public buildings. But
yeah.
We're also like, wait a minute, we don't have a $20,000 budget for this. This is dreaming a little bit too big.
No.
So we had to kind of bring it on down a little, a few notches. And,
but in that same tour, we were sort of trying to find if there were offices that weren't used, or sort of what are the areas that are not very, that we could kind of take over a little bit.
Mm-hmm.
And there, we were told there are basically no spaces in City Hall that are not used for office space or whatever needs to happen, except the only space is this kiosk at the entrance of the Van Ness entrance of City Hall. That kiosk, it has some drawings in the displays of the tour guides, yeah.
But basically empty drawers, it's an unused space for the open real estate inside the building. So it's coming down to the wire. For a couple of months we're just like walking, talking, trying to figure things out. And we like, Maysoon was like, get this proposal out. So we decided
to sit there.
From that new spot and from there. So we talked to the tour guy, Rob, who is the building manager, and said that we wanted to just sit there for a while. And he says, okay, on Tuesday there'll be two chairs in there. So we showed up and we're sitting in there to write our proposal. I found a legal pad, so that's what I wrote in literally on the thing. But it's also an unused information desk, so we are getting bombarded by questions that we didn't know how to answer. So duty called, and we had to make our official first uniform, the Office of Uninformation, no information. Still, we got questions anyway. But so we wrote our proposal and narrowed it down to just an unofficial Department of Handshakes. We thought that's one thing we can do is greet people and study the etiquette and styles of the handshake.
It's sort of a one-on-one negotiation between two people, and that sort of
City Hall is, there's a lot of negotiation going on.
Yeah,
there.
Official, non-official.
Official,
yeah.
Non-official.
So here's, we made this
Mobile research unit,
yeah, this sort of wooden stand that holds, there's Allison's painting at the top of that, and there's another painting you'll see.
Yeah, oh, there it
the other side.
So it's a mobile unit, and they said that it could, the unit can live inside the kiosk when we're not there, and then we can roll it out within the space. So it's really amazing just how open they've all been to things going on within there.
And we have a box that is for taking stories or comments that people have about their experience with the handshakes if they have comments.
So part of the thing was just making together too, you know, getting to know each other through making together. So making our aprons and patches and uniforms and our unofficial badges, because we wanted it to be as official as possible in our unofficial capacity. And just building the structure together was really fun. This is our first day.
So yeah, we've had 2 days so far, and two Fridays, and we'll have this coming Friday and February 2nd will be on site.
And basically, we've spent all our time making our stand and our uniforms and getting our official look that by the time we actually had to set up, we just had to wing it, right, what we were going to do. But uniforms help. I was in the bathroom and I met Lydia, and she came out to the stand. She saw the badge and said, "What are you doing?" She was on her break. She came out, and she's been at City Hall for 26 years now in semi-retirement. So we calculated for her, because she says she does about 15 handshakes a day, so 5 days a week for 26 years. Has done over 100,000 handshakes over her career. So she's pretty good at it.
Are you guys familiar with Merrill Eakley's Labyrinth? Okay, so I figured you must have been. Because when I first read about that you were doing this, I was thinking, well, how cool. It's kind of like, you know, futuring, get that camera off of me. Futuring that work, you know. Which is different in so many ways, but not in the sense that you guys are addressing.
Yeah, and it's,
are people aware of that work from the 70s, where she decided to shake hands with all of the sanitation department men in the morning when they were leaving on their trucks, and she did a lot of research, like, you know, looking into how they actually, like, took their breaks, where they took their breaks. Like, they like, put broken furniture in these rooms that they would have their breaks in, and she changed the whole sanitation department in New York with this work, which was really great. And
I'm actually glad you're bringing that up, because that's something we can refocus on, because each week we have to come up with kind of some other new trajectory to focus on. The first day we were just trying to facilitate handshakes between strangers. In this flu season is not always an easy task. But there's sanitation. There's the, what's a standard?
Purell
or whatever. There's stations in City Hall all around. You know,
so
it's not the handshake, it's what you do with your hands afterwards. That's what we tell people. Just don't touch your mouth or eyes. Go wash your hands. The handshake itself is fine. So
we were collecting, that first day, we were collecting images of handshakes and asking people about their handshake experiences and if they had any handshakes to show us. There were...
collecting an archive of handshakes between strangers.
So are you photographing these as they go, or how is this happening?
Some
of guy who was teaching us, he taught me the Hawaiian handshake, which I don't remember, and I was really bad at it, but
this is the New Zealand greeting.
And how are you received there from the outside, the groups of like the people who have to exist in that building all day long? How are they receiving you?
Oh, they're amazing. The from the deputy department, the people that sit at the, you know, where you call it? The security.
Security.
Amazing.
Antoine.
She was amazing. She was like telling people as they came through, today is National Handshake Day. So they're great, you know, and that's fun. And that's what I was thinking, revisiting, you know, just making our way around the different people that are, you know, just work there.
Mm-hmm. That's great. And then there was a group of women who came from,
So the first day that we were there, we had press as we were setting up, which was a little stressful because we were like, we don't even know what we're doing, you know, and trying, we don't know where we're going with this card, you know, and having to wing it as we're trying to be interviewed and sound like we know what we're doing and talking about. So we were bemoaning it a little bit.
But some people saw the article.
But it actually turned out to be a good thing because we were actually getting people. Shut up. We were getting unexpected people coming through. We had a group of women, or this one woman that brought in three people from the ARC, which is, and they were doing a whole project on handshakes from seeing that. Like they learned the handshake,
printed out a whole sheet,
a questionnaire thing for handshakes. You know, and like, and taught us something about handshakes. We were
they said hello, my name is Sue or whatever, and then we said hi, nice to meet you, and they said no, you have to say your name too. So,
which is we're there to learn. It's a research project, and researching the proper etiquette and things. So they were very helpful, and so that was a great experience. And then getting them to shake hands with strangers while they were there furthered their research too and practice.
Did you have anyone talk about the kind of more dark side of handshakes, like the aggression, like that whole Trump thing? Like I never had seen that before. This
we've had some people talk about sort of not really in relation to Trump so much, but about aggressive handshakes being a
like
problem.
If they want to squeeze too hard, I hate
that.
Or like the pulling towards you.
This new job, she met her boss and he did this thing.
Oh, yeah.
Like the flipping.
That's the other thing.
Flipping the hand over.
Yeah.
Which weirded her out. And she said she should have known something wrong. She quit 6 months later.
Oh,
she said she should have known from that first handshake.
Yeah,
you know, it's a real
power.
Domination thing,
yeah.
A power thing.
Yeah.
Uh-huh. And then people are teaching us different. One guy taught us the
extra love.
Yeah.
Extra love.
And then the creepy handshakes.
Oh yeah.
The finger, you know, the finger that goes.
Oh yeah.
Yeah.
I remember that one. You're like. Bill Bloomfield.
Growing up, my grandfather taught me to give a firm handshake. He always said you can judge somebody by how firm they shake your hand. Being a filmmaking student, I happened to meet Will Smith once. Most memorable day ever. Hashtag Will Smith handshake. Al Gore's rally. Clinton Gore. I shook Al Gore's hand. He has a good handshake. There was a lot of good energy. In general, I think handshakes are good. This is from a woman. Many men won't shake my hand until I reach out first. This makes me feel less involved and makes
me more
tentative to join the conversation.
So for our second thing, we decided we needed to introduce people to the City of San Francisco handshake.
Huh?
So if you're familiar with the seal of San Francisco. It's kind of a cluttered homogenization of a lot of history in here. So we felt like, you know, it's really appropriate that the handshake's a little awkward and cluttered too. If anybody would like to learn with us about the city of San Fran,
we'll demonstrate and then if you'd like to learn.
A little narration helps you. So,
hills and waves.
Hills and waves. Strike gold.
Earthquake.
Slap that city. Strength. Power. Phoenix rising. The handshake could probably use some improvement. So we're thinking maybe putting some word out, maybe.
So are you doing that when you arrive there each day?
Yeah.
So we started.
So you do that when you first show up?
A special handshake?
Yeah, these are people.
Oh, no, they're going to demonstrate
it. They're teaching it to everyone.
They're teaching it to everyone.
Yeah.
We collected some stills of the Phoenix.
The Phoenix. Oh, yeah.
So good.
That's pretty much where we are. We've got to figure out what we're going to do this Friday. So we're there,
there?
10 to 4.
Once a week?
Fridays.
Fridays.
Fridays. Fridays till February 2nd.
And you're just in like that main area if we come into City Hall.
Yeah, we're rolling around and we try to leave a sign of where we are, but mostly we've been in the sort of at the bottom of the stairs where people are waiting to get married.
Yeah. Yeah. So looking for good light sources or different ways where you can use both sides of the things.
Have any brides or grooms done it yet?
Yes.
Oh.
So
we're trying to get crossover between people who don't know each other, so we're trying to get like
But there are a few brides and grooms that was their actual first handshake with each other.
Lots of kisses,
everything else, but never really had a.
Should become a thing after you leave that like brides and grooms aren't officially married until they do the Phoenix Rising.
The Phoenix Rising test.
Are you pronouncing
that? Yeah. I totally get it.
You're not officially married until you go get your handshake.
Yeah,
that's cute.
Just know you can crash and burn, but the Phoenix can always ride.
Right? Yeah.